Reapings, everybody! Welcome back to another episode of Serious Quiz Adventures in Bevo Tech Pack. Today, we will be doing something very awesome. A few episodes ago, I told you guys that besides the atomic disassembler, there's one more tool in Mekanism that is even better. And today, we will work on that. Just a side note that I realized last episode, my floor design is pretty much the same color as the atomic disassembler. Interesting. But before we do that awesome tool, let's go over some things real quick. One thing I did is I finished up all this logic here. So we have the silicon, gold, diamond, and status ones. And like I mentioned last time, I put all the logic to make the final version of it into its own logic. So this thing here combines all the, you know, the silicon and the press things together. So what it does here real quick is, again, a condition, it checks if it has both the redstone and the silicon, because every recipe needs those. And then if it has them, it also checks if it has any of those types, the gold one, the diamond one, or the certus one. If it has any of those, it just puts them out into the inscriber and it does whatever it can and combines them together to the final one. So I've been making a couple of those, which is pretty awesome now. So much easier than just standing there and doing it manually. And another thing is, I started working on the AE2 Autocrafting. It is very different from the AE1 Autocrafting, so I'm still getting used to it, but it does look fancy. I have to say, it is pretty. So there are kind of two types of crafting, and I'm going to show you both, sort of. The very first one, the easy, simple version, is you pretty much only need the molecular assembler, I guess. Not the most expensive block, but this guy lets you craft things. So I'm just gonna hook it up to the AE system. And if you open it, it has like a crafting grid, and it has a slot for a blank pattern, or a, I guess, encoded pattern in this case. Similar to the AE1 crafting system, you have a pattern terminal, where you put in one of those blank patterns, like this one, for example. I have one in here that's already pre-configured. You enter your recipe, what you want to craft, and then you just save it as whatever you want. There's also a different mode now where you have like three different outputs. I believe that's for like let's say you put something in a pulverizer and you get like gold and 10% chance of something else. You can encode those things now too, so the AE system understands that. But in this case, let's give you an example. I have the encoded pattern. So it says you craft one furnace with 8 cobblestone. So all you would do is go over here, put that in the system. Now you can either feed it the blocks directly, although I don't know if it spreads them out now. You would still have to do this, which is not really auto-crafting, so we don't want to do that. Whoa, where did it? There it is. Instead, you could use like a hopper, for example, or like any pipes or something piping into it, and just give it the blocks it needs. It pulls them in one by one, and now auto-crafts that, and it outputs it back into the inventory it got them from. So that is like the first simple, very, very simple version of auto-crafting in AE2. You can build this really early on, I guess, and it looks really fancy. You can actually see the block that it's crafting inside, and has some nice lights in there. Very cool. But obviously this is not very good. It's only one recipe per block. So we want to do something more fancy, which in this case is, did it drop something? No. It's what this is. It's again, molecular assembler, but it is connected to an ME interface, and they are pretty much the same thing as an AE1. If you put them next to like different machines, it can communicate with your AE system. But in this case, what you do is you put the patterns, I have like two different patterns here, one to make, if you hold shift, you can actually see what it crafts, one to make those quartz fibers, and then using quartz fibers and some other things to make the ME cable. So you put them into the interface this time. You don't have like a giant cube, computer cube anymore that carries those patterns. You actually have to put them into the ME interface now. There is a block that you can make that displays every single interface that is connected to your AE system, and you can easily put in the pattern and take them out again. But in this case, it's just one simple setup, and it has to be next to a molecular assembler. So if you do this, you will also need the crafting storage. And this is kind of the crafting computer now. It's a multi-structure block too. I have like an extra one, I believe. Yeah, I have like this crafting unit, which doesn't do anything on its own, but that's what you use to make all the other components for your crafting computer, bigger storage drives, stuff like that. It always has to be like square, or not square, but like a rectangle. You can't have like a L shape, for example, something like that. So right now this block doesn't actually do anything. Only this guy does, the 1K storage unit. So what this allows you to do is actually autocraft. So since we have the patterns in here hooked up to our AE system and it's attached to the assembler and we have the crafting storage, we can now search instead of what we have stored here, we can go to just craftables, for example, and it shows you what we have. Now, if I wanted to craft like 10 ME cable, I click next. It shows you, okay, you have 3 flux cable or crystals, but you're missing 3, so you can't actually do it. Start button doesn't show you that you can do it. So it actually recognizes that before it starts crafting. Now, in the old one, it would just try to do it and it would say missing items and would wait for you to finish it up, like give it the items. And it also shows you how much byte it uses. And I believe the more you try to craft, so if you do like 1,000, the more bytes it uses. Now, in this case, it uses 2,870 bytes to make this, to execute this crafting job. But it can't do that because we only have a 1K drive. So I wouldn't even be able to do that. That's why you need those bigger drives and then create like a big multi-structure out of it to support more beyond that. But let's just make one. We should be able to do that. We only need 2 for that. And then it shows you which crafting CPU you want to use to craft it. You can say just choose automatic, or for some reason you can choose a specific one if that's what you need. And also shows you how much storage it has. But then all you do is click start, and then it will show you up, will craft the items, and there it is. I already had some. That's why it's, I think at 16 always makes 4 or something. So yeah, that's a very rough explanation of the AE2 autocrafting. I'll go into more details later when we actually start making something big out of it. It's very different. It looks a little bit more complicated. I wouldn't say more complicated, but it's more pieces to it. It's not just one cube that does things. But it does really allow you to set up the crafting system the way you want. For example, one of those assemblers can only do one job at a time. You can also add upgrades later to speed it up and stuff like that. For example, if you want, like, let's say you have a recipe in here for making, I don't know, turn like locks into planks or something, and you don't just want one assembler to do it, you want like 4 assemblers to do it, you can just put multiple assemblers around the interface that has the recipe, and it will split it among those assemblers. It won't just use one, it will use all the available around it, so you can have like up to 5 assemblers next to an interface to do jobs quicker, to do multiple items at once. Or you can do the opposite. If you want to have things that you don't craft a lot, like for example those cables, you just do them once, but you have like a lot of recipes that only need to be crafted rarely, you can put multiple interfaces around one assembler, so that way you have like multiple pattern assigned to one assembler that does all the things. So you can really like split it up depending on what you want. But yeah, like I said, we go over this in a different video. But now it is time to make the best item in Mekanism. It is the digital miner. Oh baby, I prepared all the items. It is not a very cheap recipe, but it's also not super expensive. It requires a lot of those atomic alloys, which need reinforced or refined obsidian dust, which also need diamond dust. By the way, this is something Altana told me. In this recipe right now, it shows you need 1 diamond dust and 1 enriched alloy to make one of those things. But sometimes it shows you that you can use the compressed version. The compressed one actually lets you create 10 times as many items. So you can actually, with 1 compressed diamond dust, you can create 10 of those things. And the way you get a compressed version is just by putting it into your enrichment chamber instead of putting it into a crusher that would turn it just into the dust. And that applies to the redstone and the coal ones too. So you can actually get a lot more out of one diamond than just one item. You can get 10 out of it, which is kind of cool. But yeah, I prepared all the items. Oops, wrong item. And we will craft it. Oh yeah, baby. This is the best thing ever. Let me put away some things. Oh boy, this is a big block. You place it in the world. And it's kind of like a... actually, let me grab this too. Like a quarry, but a bit smarter. Let me... I made like an advanced energy cube here to store some energy. Because I actually don't have glowstone to make another one of those guys. Because you need one to power this guy, right? So I made this for now. It's not the best solution, but it will do for now. Let me show you what this guy does. Let's put it down. Bam! Oh yeah! It is a, I believe, 3x3 structure and 2 high or 3 high, I'm not sure. Right now it doesn't do much. It looks cool. But if you open its interface, it has several options here. First of all, like I said, it is a quarry, so you can actually, you can decide to auto-eject everything it quarries, you can decide to silk-touch everything you want to quarry. Notice though, right now it would use 80 RF, if you say silk-touch, it would use 480 RF, so it's quite more expensive energy-wise, but it's definitely worth it. And auto-pull is for, if you provide it with a chest from the top, for example, that has like cobblestone or dirt or whatever inside, it will use those blocks to fill all the holes it created. So it's very cool. I'm not going to do that for now, though. Maybe in the future, but for now, I'll just leave this. And then what you do is you go to config, and you actually specify which items you want and in what range. The maximum radius it can check is 32 blocks. It's not a super big range, but I mean, you can just keep moving this guy. And you can specify from which Y level to, you know, minimax Y level. And then you set up an item filter. So if you just want to dig ores, for example, you can, you know, either specify every single ore you want, or use the ore dictionary and go like ore star, which means like anything that contains this name, save. And then here you see it like goes through all the different ores that it would find. And then if you go back to the site actually and would click start, right now it doesn't have power, it doesn't do anything, but just clicking start shows you how many ores it found. So in this 32 by 32 radius from Y level 60 to 0, it found 10,517 ores to mine. So you don't have to mine dirt, you don't have to mine cobblestone, you don't have to deal with that. You just pull out the goodies you want. And I'm actually low on gold, for example, so I'm curious. I believe it's all gold. You can also use like, you can put like an item in here maybe not in this one, but like in the item stack, you can put an item in here and it automatically sets it to whatever you want. But you can also just type it in. So let's do gold ore. There we go. I want to see how many, because I have trouble finding gold. There's 114 gold ore, not a lot in a 32 by 32 radius. That's not a lot. I might actually mine this up one day, but not today. One thing I want right now, I'm completely out of glowstone, and the glowstone in the nether is really hard to reach. So let's pick this guy up. I believe we can just break him, but just in case, I'm gonna use the wrench. So let me think. I have a chest to output things. I have the cube to give him energy. I actually made some energy upgrades, so if you put them into the machine, it will lower the cost, the energy cost. So hopefully we can do silk touch and lower the cost by quite a bit. And I brought a work anchor. I feel like the digital miner kind of counts as a chunk loader, but I'm not 100% sure anymore. So just in case, I'm going to bring the world anchor and we're going to test this out. So let's quickly see. But I actually did wait for the server to reset this time. So it is after 3 a.m. I might be tired. I might sound tired. Still haven't done anything about this, obviously. One day. I'm not sure what though. We'll see. But it's kinda dangerous. So we will go to the nether. Real quick update outside here maybe. I did a lot of caving and I found those essence berry bushes. They sometimes give you animals allowed. Oh hey Pikmin. They sometimes give you concentrated essence berry, and if you eat them, you actually get experience points. Really cool. You're friendly, right? Okay. Just gonna eat my drink here. Also collected some sheeps and cows, so I finally have a little farm going on there. By the way, a little tip for the food situation. You know how if you eat something, it always says eaten once out of the last eight food, and after a while, let's see, actually, can I eat something? Since I restart, I don't think that's accurate. So it says, no, eaten once still, okay. But what I do is, if you ever run into this problem where it's like all of your food is has a low nutritional value, get those berries. Not because you wanna heal up yourself, but you can just eat them. Like if I eat seven berries now, and they're very small, so you can eat a lot of them very quickly. So if I just eat them a bunch, and they grow really fast, it resets all of my food. So all of them are actually back at 100%. So, just a little tip if you ever run out of food. Did I bring some blocks? I hope I brought some blocks. Alright, let's see. Oh god, Enderman. Why are you here? Did you. Are you angry? Some wisps. Oh, I'm getting some lag. Oh god, I hate the nether. Wisps are never good. They're very aggressive. Let's kill him, actually. He was getting too close to me. They zap you and they deal a lot of damage. They are from Thaumcraft. Did they get his little. Yeah, I did. His essence. Cool. My portal is messed up. I'm not sure why. I think a gas hit it. Oh, wait a second. Uh-oh. Okay. Interesting. Before I had a bottom piece here. Well, let's be careful. Maybe that's why the cobblestone was there. Maybe someone placed it to get out of here. This guy, man. Okay. Yeah, you can see a lot of the glowstone is actually on the ceiling. It's really hard to get. So I'm just gonna put the guy down here. And we will see what we can find. So to get those energy upgrades, you just put them in this little slot over here. Right now you see speed upgrade is times one, energy is times one. So you can also get speed upgrades. It takes up to eight of each. So you just. Okay, maybe not there. Can I just shift click them in there? There we go. Probably because any eyes over there. You just put them in and you see it slowly installs them. If you click on this, I believe you just click once, maybe it's shift click, you remove them again so you don't have to waste them or anything. So now we're actually getting down quite a bit. So before I was using 40, now let's see with Silk Touch it was 480, 96. So much better. All right, so let's get rid of this because we don't want that. All I want right now really is. And I don't know what the ore dictionary for glowstone is, but I enabled it in NEI. It's just glowstone. Okay. So we just want this. Okay. 32. Max, I'm gonna do. I believe the ceiling is still 128 or something. I don't think it's 250, whatever. Oh no, wait, it is. No. 73. Yeah, that should be fine. The nether is only 128. Okay. That should be good. And also I want obviously what's it called? Nether quartz. Huh, what is your name? Ore quartz, okay. Let's put that in there. There we go. Is there anything else I should mine? I don't think there is. There are some ores in the nether, but I don't think I care about them. Let's see how much we find. Silk touch, auto eject on that. Oh, that does add energy too. Oh well. All right, let's see. Auto pull is off. Please, I can't talk. 3,124. Awesome. And the best part about this machine is the output of your items is through his butt. Oh yeah, he just poops out the items. I'm like a child. All right, let's add this thing. And once it starts, it actually gets a little funny face. It's hard to place those guys because they're only output through one face, through one side. So you can't. Oh. Oh, go away. You scare me. Go away, Wisp. Oh man, that scared me so much. Luckily, I have good armor. I don't have any arrows on me. And I'm a slow sand, so I'm not the best at fighting it. Wow, that scared me so much. Alright. Let's try to place this. The guy's in the way. Can I place. I only brought one cobblestone. I didn't even bring that. That was here already. Where would I be placing it? There, I guess. His collision is in the way. Nope. Can I rotate this? No. Dang it. How am I going to place this now? Maybe it can come from below. God. Come on. Let me just place this cube, please. There you go. That didn't work, though, did it? Oh, no. It's getting energy. Aha! Hello there! Hello to you too, awesome machine. Please do your job. Whoa. A little bit of lag there. Awesome. I like this guy so much. Oops, don't break him. Give me that back. Are you mining stuff? I think yes, he is. So I wonder how long this lasts. I'm not... Oh god, it doesn't last very long. So I think I definitely have to make one of those... energy transmitters again. Ah, but there it is. Slowly but surely. Like I said, you can install speed upgrades to make this a little bit faster, but that will also consume my energy. Yeah, it's draining quite a bit. So I won't do that for now. Do I have... I guess I use a flammable block here just to get out again. Let's see. Right now it's at 3,108. I'm going to go outside and I'm going to see... Come on. I'm gonna see if it's chunk loaded or not. 3,110 or something, right? 108. Something like that. I'm gonna wait a few minutes and I'll be right back. Alright, before we go back in, maybe just a quick update on the bee situation. I've been just breeding a bunch of bees at the moment. Right now I'm doing the... Are you... burning, but what? That sounded like lava. That was weird. Anyway, I added some bees here. So right now I'm doing the forest ones. I'm trying to get like a stack of each drone. I finished the meadow one, and I also finished the modest one, which is the desert. So after the forest one. I don't like that sound. I don't know what that is. I assume it's the guy, but... Oh, is he burning? Oh, maybe he starts burning or something. Anyway, after that I'm gonna do the jungle ones here, the marshy ones, I mean. And I believe the wintry? No. I thought I had wintry ones. Are they called forest now? Maybe they're called forest now. Where are they? I thought I had different ones. Anyway, let's go back. So it's been a few minutes. So it should be probably at like 3,000 or something. I don't know. We'll see. If it doesn't work, I'll put the world anchor there and add a ender pearl to let it run for 12 hours. Okay, portal's still there. I do have a flint and steel with me, but we also have an extra portal all the way down there. Okay, how are you doing? 3,009. No. Okay, it's not chunk loaded. I think it was at 3,108. Or was it? Oh, it's so hard to tell. You know what? Just in case, we'll put it here. It doesn't hurt to put it here. How are you doing? I think I'll do have to make it. But I do have a glowstone now, so I can actually do it. Because I was all out of glowstone. But yeah, that's a digital miner. So. This guy, amazing. And we will use this in overworld to farm some gold later too. But I think that will do it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys like this machine as much as I do. I never seen that. I just saw that. That must be new. It looks like a cow now. Interesting. Maybe that extends when it starts digging. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye bye!